In this episode, we're going to look at how you can get the most for your hard-earned cash, because a premium sedan like this can drain your wallet faster than a Canadian gas station in July. And if there were an answer to this question, it could be this, the 2024 Genesis G70 with the new 2.5T engine. What's it like? Buckle up, my friends. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max Racer, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now for 2024, the G70 has one major update, a bunch of minor ones, but the major one is the 2-liter four-cylinder turbo is gone, and it's been replaced with the 2.5-liter four-cylinder turbo that we've seen in other Genesis models. And before we get into what this is like to drive, let's have a look at it in a little more depth. Like I said, there are a bunch of updates, nothing major. There's some new wheel designs and the brakes are upgraded and there's some different colors, USB-C ports inside the cabin. But otherwise, the big difference is, of course, this engine. Here it makes 300 horsepower at 5,800 RPM and 311 pounds of torque from 1,650 to 4,000 RPM. Those numbers are up 48 horsepower and 51 pounds of torque. The transmission's still an 8-speed automatic. In the US, you have your choice of rear-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. In Canada, it's all-wheel drive only. The rear diff is the open kind on the four-cylinder. The V6 G70 does get an electronically controlled limited slip diff. Electric power steering, of course. McPherson struts up front, multi-link at the rear, conventional dampers on the four-cylinder G70, four-piston calipers at the front, two-piston at the rear, and that's the brake upgrade that we're talking about. Big rotors as well, 13.8 on the front and 13.4 on the rear.
Yes, there are some new wheel designs. Really not a fan of black wheels, but what are you gonna do? Curb weight of the G70 2.5T is between 3,800 and 3,900 pounds, depending on your spec.
Did you know that about 80% of you are not subscribed? Yes, it's true. I checked the data and 80% of you are not subscribed. So if you enjoy the content on this channel, do me a solid, hit that subscribe button while you're at it. Be sure to like this video and share it. And if you don't mind, drop by our merch store. There's lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Now back to your regularly scheduled episode.
I am a big fan of the seating position. This is absolutely dialed. Plenty of adjustment in the seat and the steering column. The steering wheel is shaped perfectly, encourages you to have your hands at 9 and 3 where they should be. And first level ergonomics, just absolutely dialed. Great visibility here as well. Really can't complain about how you've been set up as a driver, because I got a great relationship to the steering wheel and a great relationship to the pedals. Another thing I really dig about the interiors of any Genesis is how straightforward the ergonomics are. It's very simple, very straightforward, no learning curve if you're new to Genesis. And if you're familiar with Genesis, well, you're gonna be right at home. It's very simple, straightforward. This infotainment system is a riff on their existing ones. Similar interface, but without the dial controller, whatever Genesis calls it. So it is a touchscreen, very easy to deal with. I use it on Apple CarPlay and works perfectly for me. Don't mind the sound system at all. It seems to be quite good to my race car abused ears. There is wireless charging for your phone, old school USB port, and a bunch of USB-C ports in here. First row spaciousness, just fine. You and your passenger are gonna be quite comfortable, and that's fine. I can just fit behind myself in the seating position in that second row. So take that into consideration if you are looking at this as a 4 or 5 passenger vehicle, but that second row can be tight. Yeah, this is pretty quick. It'll do 0 to 60 in about 5.5 seconds. Not bad for a four-cylinder turbo at all. Top speed's about 150 miles an hour. And again, for a four-cylinder sedan, that's not bad at all. What I really do like about this engine is the way it delivers power and torque. On top of that, you do have manual control of the gearbox, which we'll talk about in a bit. But I really love the way this engine delivers power and torque. Maybe the only downside is that it does sound like a four-cylinder from time to time, but it is very smooth in operation, makes a massive amount of torque from low in the rev range all the way through the meaty part of the rev range. So you're never
ever at a loss for torque. And then when you do rev it up to near redline, whenever it is 6,000 RPM or so, maybe a little bit more, it still rewards you with all of its power. In the right hands, this 2.5T can be very efficient, and good news, it's still powered by gasoline. Sorry, Greta. I do love the responsiveness of this gearbox for an automatic. It's properly responsive. It's really not lost against the competition. It does exactly what it's supposed to do. You want to control it manually, no problem at all. And on top of that, there are different drive modes, and of course, they do have a Sport Plus, is that what it's called? A Sport Plus mode where traction and stability are backed off a little bit. So find that interesting. Not that there is any loss of sure-footedness. This thing is extremely sure-footed in terms of the way it puts down power, and I suppose could be a little bit tail-happy near its limits, but this is no hardcore sport sedan. It's a middle-of-the-road sport sedan meant to compete against other four-cylinder premium sedans, and it does a very good job at that in terms of its performance. That's the thing. This is not the 3.5T with a massive amount more torque and horsepower. This is the 2.5T and makes a more than modest amount of power and torque, but you're never overwhelming the all-wheel drive system. You're never overwhelming the diff in the rear. It'd be fun to try this in the winter. And speaking of which, we are still on winter tires, even though we're well into the spring here, and there's a little bit of extra tire noise coming from these tires. One thing that the Genesis Dynamics engineers have done is found a great balance between ride comfort and handling. The overall ride comfort is quite good, and body and wheel control is excellent for just regular dampers. They've done an excellent job tuning the suspension for, you know, this middle of the road space. It's not offensive to anybody, and then when we go and hustle this through the corners, it's still fairly satisfying. What I do find, though, is that there is a little bit more body roll than I would like, and I understand why they do it, and that's just fine, but doesn't really put me off. It allows the suspension to work, certainly, and, you know, over rough roads like this, it is definitely comfortable. So they've done a great job of finding that balance. When you are near its limits, it's fairly neutral, and it's wonderfully responsive when you're near its limits through the corners. It doesn't really want to push, and you're otherwise very confident when you're behind the wheel of this G70, because it gives you a lot of confidence in the corners. Steering is very clear, it's direct, does exactly what you want it to do. I can point it so precisely. Love it for that. There's also the right amount of heft to the steering, and it's strong on center. Really can't complain about it. They've done a great job. Just would love a touch more feel and feedback through the steering wheel. Through the chassis, however, communication is very clear. I can feel what's going on at each of the four corners. Really appreciate how they've tuned the suspension that way to give me the feedback that I'm looking for. With the upgraded brakes, especially the multi-piston calipers on the front, I've got precise control with this brake pedal. Really appreciate how they've tuned this as well. And, you know, just for fun, let's get into the brakes here. Very, very clear, very precise feel, feedback, modulation, all top-notch. Definitely above average for the segment, and really appreciate that. Again, when we're hustling this thing, if you're enjoying it in the corners, well, you've got precise control with that brake pedal as well. You don't necessarily need to rely on the steering wheel to adjust the attitude of the car. I'm very confident on that brake pedal when we're throwing it into corners, like diving into a corner. You've got very, very precise control and great feel, so you know exactly what's going on with the brakes and those contact patches. How do you spec yours? Well, if you're in the US, not like this, because the product planners in the United States did not make these colors available to you. What you are looking at is the Capri blue paint and the Dune and black interior, which is elegant, and again, Canada only, my friends. Base price in the US for a rear drive 2.5T is $41,500. And as tested, this is $48,450. In Canada, base price for an all-wheel drive 2.5T is $54,500. And as tested, this is $59,000 even. That's before freight and local taxes. And at those prices, this is a veritable bargain in the segment. It is extremely well priced, and if you look at the competition spec for spec, this is a definite bargain. And on top of that, Genesis makes the entire purchase experience and ownership experience a little bit more premium than some of the competitors do. My verdict? Well, let's start with fuel consumption, because some of you will ask, and I'm getting about 20 miles per gallon, about 12 liters per 100 kilometers from my Canadian friends. That's primarily in-city driving, which is impressive for me because I do enjoy using the throttle. I think on more open roads like here in the countryside, I do a little bit better, but in stop-and-go traffic in the city, that's about as good as I'm gonna get. Now, compared to some of the European rivals, this G70 with a 2.5T delivers similar levels of performance, features, and maybe even a better warranty, all for a significantly lower price. And you're not sacrificing anything if you're looking for something that has a little bit of value but still delivers on all the luxury features that you want, as well as the performance and dynamics that you want for a car like this. And on top of that, its price tag won't leave you hawking your soul on some Hollywood street corner. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2024 Genesis G70 with the 2.5T. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Genesis sports sedans.